In the hit show Money Heist, we are intrinsically captured as the professor and his team outsmart the police time and time again until they eventually escape with $984 million. At first glance, the show provides an alluring view of how exactly a team of robbers pull off each step of the heist and their mental struggles along the way. But something that is often overlooked is the various teases at economic issues along the way. So, here's the real economic significance of the first heist. Starting off, in one of the most memorable scenes from the first two seasons, the professor provides some insight into the scope of their actions. Near the end of the heist, in the hangar, the professor tells the inspector that in 2011, the European Central Bank made 171 billion euros out of nothing, 185 billion in 2012, and 145 billion euros in 2013. This statement is what eventually gets the inspector to question which side is the good side and side with the professor. Are these numbers just made up to fit in with the storyline of the show, or is there some truth to this? Well, this money was not actually printed as he suggests, but the principle he is questioning is more than accurate, as over 3 trillion euros have been injected into the economy since 2008 by the European Central Bank. This amount is over 3,000 times more than what the robber stole. And in reality, these liquidity injections literally do come from thin air, as the professor suggests, as these were digital transactions. So, some mornings, European central banks literally wake up with more money in their account. This process is not originally designed to be a sinister legal way of counterfeiting money like the professor suggests, but over the years, it has somewhat evolved into that. This process is actually a legitimate economic strategy called quantitative easing, and it is supposed to help stimulate the economy during deep economic recessions like 2008 financial crisis. This technique is only used when all other conventional methods of stimulating the economy have failed, like lowering interest rates. Generally, interest rates have already bottomed out at zero, and the only thing the Fed or central bank can do to help the economy is to increase the actual quantity of money. So, they simply give themselves money, ex nihilo, or out of nothing. This newly created money is supposed to be given out to banks and companies to help them continue operation at no interest. And this is ideally supposed to prevent companies and banks from laying people off and encourage them to lend out money to stimulate the economy. But this is not what generally happens. You see, when banks and companies get this money, they don't invest very much of it into lending out money or creating more jobs. The thing is, these don't provide much returns for the institutions. Interest rates are at the bottom and banks aren't really incentivized to lend out money at 3 or 4% interest. Instead, they logically think about where they can make the most money, which is in the stock market. The stock market is in shambles and it has common sense that it's going to return sooner or later, at which point they can make 20-30% returns, maybe even much more. Of course, they're not stupid. They're not investing in startups or long-shot companies. Instead, they invest in stable industry leaders like energy and communication companies that will surely rebound. So, they're fairly safe investments. But the thing is, this money is helping the banks as opposed to the people of the country. Sure, this money would indirectly help people as this invested capital into companies would eventually grow jobs and whatnot. But when banks and companies are taking a 20-30% cut of this money, you can see how quantitative easing can be very ineffective at helping the intended audience, and this is precisely what the first heist attacks. It's clear that the professor actually has no intention of stealing money or hurting civilians or really causing any harm at all. The money is simply something he uses to get people to work for his cause. We can see this as the professor often describes his team as the resistance and his deep care for the hostages and safety of his team members. This is further confirmed by Berlin and the professor singing Bella Ciao, which was the anthem used for the anti-fascist resistance. The professor sees themselves as a peaceful resistance to certain economic policies and wants the public on their side. And all the rules and plans implemented in the heist perfectly align with this motive. One of the most important rules was to cause no harm to anyone in order to get public support. And even if the money heist completely failed, Plan Chernobyl suggested to disperse the printed money to the public. Economically speaking, even if the team was able to print the full 2.4 billion euros, nothing would happen. The team would have to print 30 billion euros to simply print 1% of what the European Central Bank has injected over the past 12 years. So, the team is by no way causing any real inflation or economic instability. And all of this isn't just to be the Robin Hood of some fake public in the show, but rather garner the support of the viewer. Most of you guys probably wanted the heist to succeed. They hadn't hurt anyone, they treated their hostages with respect, and they weren't really stealing from anyone specifically. Ironically, a lot of viewers hated Arturo the most. In a classical heist movie where the robbers are the bad guys, Arturo may have very well been the hero. Anyways, in the end, though Money Heist is proposed as a thrilling series of robberies, it is actually much more than that. It is actually a brilliant, intriguing method to shed light onto various economic issues that are often overlooked, starting with quantitative easing in the first heist. Do you guys agree? Make sure to comment that down below, and subscribe if you'd like to see more questions logically answered. But until then, I'm Hari, and I'll see you guys on the next one.